Oh, the enemies have an Illudonger again? Alright. Illudonger? Dahaka's actually pretty good against Illidan. They also have Medivh, that's very interesting. So basically, they need a warrior, and they are going to have one ranged assassin at max. And they're not going to have a strong warrior because Muradin is now banned. So we have insane global mobility, and we have a really strong front line. Not sure if KT is good here, though. If I were the support pick right now, I would probably go Karazim. Because Karazim 7-sided can really punish an Illidan who goes too deep. Uther, I was going to say, is cool too. We haven't seen Uther in a very long time, but Uther with a stun against Illidan is really, really good too. Also with an ETC, I mean, being able to Divine Shield one of your frontliners is always nice. So I'm actually going to say that the enemy team also doesn't have a lot of AoE damage, and they won't get a lot of AoE damage by any time. Since they can only pick one ranged assassin max, right? So Uther, I think, is actually a really, really nice choice here. The more I think about it, the more I like it. I don't think Muradin needs a nerf, it's just other warriors that need a little bit of a buff in their defensive talent trees and their defensive abilities, maybe. So we'll take Varian, for example, right? Varian could be, or could be, become, I should say, a solo tank, or a tank in general. But due to the fact that he's not able to really tank anything pre-level 10, makes him super weak in that regard. And even at level 10, his taunt feels kind of underwhelming. So they definitely need to step up the game of other warriors slash tanks. Alright, we're gonna go for... Do they have a lot of ability damage? No, they don't, actually. But you know what? We're gonna go for the move speed. We're gonna distract the Vale. We can region up. Oh jeez, really? Okay, now we're just gonna have to wait a little. Thanks for the heal, brother. I'm actually gonna solo lane here. Are we gonna get him? Ah, oh, KT. Ah, the stun was weak. So KT actually gave him an escape mechanism and also missed the stun. Nice vault. Did KT go convection, by the way? He did not. Interesting. Okay, we definitely want to get rid of that scouting drone at some point. Against the Stormridge brothers here. Almost had the Malfurion there. That's usually not very good. That's why you don't wander around too much as and now I wasted my Brush Stalker, because I thought he would be in some serious trouble. Nothing really major happened, though. I can hold this lane against Illidan because I got my own sustain. Now he took a lot of shots from the towers. To the healing fountain. Oh, nice. That was nice by KT. This guy. What's with the beast stepping, man? That was a very nice kill, though. But I guess he's allowed to cheer a little bit. Alright, cool. Uther coming in. Gotta be a little bit careful, though. Sniped. Well met. Uther just came by, passed by, you know, and was like, well met. So far, so good. Okay. We're gonna go for a Symbiosis here, which is really good. Gives you way more damage. I can't really hold the lane against two. I would also like to roam a little bit more, but I guess it's okay. At least I'm able to farm a couple of stacks for my enhanced agility. Oh, now we gotta be careful though. Sometimes I really hate the fact that the tongue animation is so slow on Dehaka. Careful. Ooh, Tychus, no! Oh, good cleanse! But yeah, that was a bad dash by Tychus. He should have actually dashed like straight vertical, and then he would have been safe. Okay, we're going back, and we're coming out here. Nice stun by KT, man. KT turning it up! Nice, we get our nuke here. Lot of essence. Get another brush stalker ready soon. The enemies still have one nuke. Teams are even in XP. Just gonna keep an eye on that bottom lane. Oh jeez, oh jeez. Now we need to brush stalk there. 100%. Like, I basically didn't want them to get the boss for free. Yeah, look, enhanced agility allows me to easily run away from those guys. Easy. Easy peasy. Uh-oh, the enemies are 10. Uh-oh, bad news. Ooh, bad news. Just a little bit unlucky. But that's okay. Just a little bit unlucky. Next team fight's gonna go a lot smoother. Are we going in? Alf would have been such a good target to focus, guys. Malf would have been the right target to focus. Okay. Oh, Illidan must be nearby. Illidan must be nearby, yes. Oh, nice. He took the bosses in escape route. So smart. So cheeky. And we're getting the fort out of this. Really cool. Nice, we got a fort. Okay, let's get the mouth. We can. That was too early. Thought my team would actually get into a real team fight here. All warheads have been claimed. Well, that for Brush Stalker was a little bit too early, unfortunately. One for one on the nukes, though. Careful. It might just be the Medivh who's trying to. Yeah, they're doing the Merc Camp over here. ETC holding! Oh. We got this though! Oh, they took the boss though. Oh, I didn't even know. I didn't even notice. We need to take this boss now. Illidan probably soloed it. I'm tempted to, oh, we don't have our healer anymore, guys. Let's run, let's run. We won't be able to make it. Just checking if they are going to continue attacking it. That's okay, the keep or fort is gonna stand. That was a crazy fight. Yep, they could actually do that boss. Nobody died? Holy moly. Actually gonna teleport back. Don't wanna lose my nuke and I'll come back refreshed. Go for the mouth, guys. Go for the mouth. Nice, nice laser. Very nice fight, guys. Really good fights. Slowly but surely, we're catching up. And we're getting there. And we're also having 8 stacks already, which is pretty good. Our roofing speed is actually really, really fast right now. Oh, come on, kill him! Oh, kill him, boys! Oh my god! Okay, we can't burrow just yet. We're not gonna burrow in, though. Johanna gave her life. Nice. Okay, the long sticky tongue. That's exactly what we want, guys. We're gonna lick a few people here. Illidan might actually be doing the boss, guys. I'm just gonna double check. No, he did not. Okay. Just wanted to check. Just wanted to check. Yeah, I'm gonna defend here. I think I can save the fort. Illidan is here, okay. Good to know. But I'm just gonna save the fort. Oh man. Sneaky. And these guys are dealing so I don't think I can hold it. No, can't hold it. Okay. They're taking all the Mercants right now. There's no bush. That portal, though. That life-saving portal. Illidan is a boss. He could be top, yes. I agree. I'm gonna check. Oh my god, you gotta be kidding me. Oh my god. I'm gonna try to pick up that nuke. Back in the Phoenix with you! Okay, that might have actually saved my life. Oof. One for one trade. Boss is gonna tear down our top keep though. We do have two nukes though. So many messy games today. They're doing this, guys. They're not doing this. Okay. They're going middle. I just want to watch the world burn. Two people here. I can't fight two. Nice cleanse. Really good cleanse though. I need to put the nuke there to save the keep. Hello! Go for the mouth, guys. I'm gonna be able to chase them. Tyke is coming from the back. What the? Can we end? Yeah, take all of the nukes. Ooh, Kendrick with the plays! Coming in. I'm gonna chase them. I will get them. Where is he going? Oh no, he was here! I didn't even look. I didn't even look, guys. Can you believe it? I didn't even expect he was there. Never lucky. Mouth. Yeah, go, boss now, okay. Untouchable. I'm gonna refill my mana real quick. Actually, I'm gonna push this lane real quick. They can't kill me. I'm not gonna lead them to our allies who are doing the boss right now. There goes the shrink ray. And we've got 3 nukes, guys. Pick up the remaining one, yes. Wait. 4 nukes? That's gonna be game. I think. And we, my def. I think it's gonna be alright. Yeah, it's gonna be alright. Never mind. Let's not panic here. Let's not panic, guys. We used too many nukes already. We used too many nukes already, I think. We still have 2, which could be enough. There goes 1. There goes 1. Oh. Let's get out of here. Oh, no, no, no. We can finish? No, we can't finish. We could have finished, but I didn't see it. I was too panicked. Sorry, guys. I was panicked. It's easy to see that when you're watching, but when you're basically trying to kill stuff, you know. Also, never lucky. Uther will come back, though. Uther will come back. That's alright. Yeah, the second nuke on the keep was not necessary. I agree. Not sure who used it. One was necessary to break through, but the other one was not necessary. You know what we're gonna do, though? We're gonna play cat and mouse. Just gonna scout ahead here. Guys are doing it. Found him this time. It might be too risky. KT is still not with us, guys. It's way too risky. We're gonna play a little game here. It is called Threaten the Core.
Hatred of 10,000 years.
See you. See you. Sorry, guys, I can't reach out right now. I need to be super focused here. And we got the boss. Now we go. Guys, go with the boss? What the hell? Okay, let's go for this boss now. Okay, with this boss we end then. JB here. JB. Up. Of course. Yes, baby! MVP. That was pretty good game. The boss was so critical though, and it was so risky at the same time. It could have gone either way, pretty much. But I think we baited out a couple of spells really, really well. And also that divine shield from Uther was just super duper important. But yeah. So yeah, basically guys, Warhead Junction is so good for Dehaka in the late game, especially after 20. Because you can really, you know, play cat and mouse with the enemy team. You can really force their attention on the one lane, and by the time they actually arrive, you're just gonna be peacing out and you're like, haha, it's gonna take you ages to, you know, catch up to where we're currently at, which was the top boss. I'm gonna talk through my build a little bit here. So, the level 1 talent was Enhanced Agility. I didn't really like the ability shield or the ability damage reduction at level 1 here because, let's face it, they didn't really have a lot of ability damage except for Medivh maybe. So I really thought, you know, Enhanced Agility, especially against an Illidan, against a Vala, that could be really useful to either run away from them with increased movement speed or to catch up to them. Then I went for the one who collects, because I think minions are just way more reliable to increase your essence than heroes. Symbiosis, because it's by far the best talent level 7. Being able to constantly have your W up is really, really good and gives Dehaka a lot of damage. Isolation, I think, also very, very much superior to what is called adaptation. Then we have Ferocious Stalker. The movement speed works extremely well with Apex Predator, or Predator. So those two talents have a lot of synergy, and I like that quite a bit. The Longer Tongue also helps you to really get those ground control effects done when you really need them. I think we had a couple of good Licky Sticky Tongues, but all in all, Dehaka's 16 talents aren't really that great, so you may as well just go with a Longer Tongue, right? And here, I think, that was the game changer. The Apex Predator allows you to basically use your Brush Stalker super, super frequently, right? And you can really appear in top lane. After 5 seconds, guess what, guys? You're gonna dive down to the bottom and so on and so forth. And it's really, really cool to see. But you really need to have a lot of map awareness as well in order to make it work, right? You can't just be sitting in lane and be like, okay, I'm just gonna push no matter what. And then by not paying attention, by not looking at the minimap, you're gonna find yourself surrounded. And Johanna could have actually interrupted me a couple of times with Blessed Shield or the Condemn. So, yeah, that was actually a little bit of luck on my side as well. So, yeah, I hope you liked that game, guys. I really hope you did. And let me know what your own Dehaka build variations might be. And so long. See you in the next video.